This game is rated M for mature, for violence, adult themes, and drills to the torso. Viewer discretion advised. Hello, ladies, gentlemen, and otherwise. I'm Lamar Haven. Welcome back to Bioshock 2.
We have to get you out of Rapture, Father. It's the only way I can save you now.
Well, that summarizes what's supposed to be happening. Very well for me. Click the button.
Beginning admission sequence.
What are you trying to point me at? Oh.
Don't you recognize Sinclair, Delta?
Sinclair.
Now he is what you should have been. One final Alpha series, ready to die for the family. As Persephone's former owner, he is the ideal man to put you back in your cage.
Mother's controlling Sinclair, Father, and he's got the master key. Catch him!
She managed to turn Sinclair into a big daddy. Not good.
Lamps in my head. I can't help myself. I have to fight just to talk. Left me my goddamn tongue to torture the bomb codes out of me. She wants me to stop you leaving. I'm sorry.
Sinclair, love him or hate him, for some of the things he suggested you do, at the end of the day, he's just another victim to Lamb's manipulations. So we've gotta help him, or at least end it. Freeze! Give me something else, give me something else to play with. Uh-oh. You! Cease this instant! Come on. Got him. Not enough for a new level up on the thing, but whatever. Alright, now that I've took care of that, I didn't get to go into the room, which would have made that an easier fight, probably, because of you. If I'd managed to hack that before everything happened, that would have been nice. This is one of those situations where the scout plasmid would have been super useful. Ugh. Everything in here is all gross and deteriorating.
This place is the absolute definition of despair. Here we are, locked away from the outside world, suspended over a pit with no hope of release. And what's our charge? Ryan has no room for differences of opinion in his precious rapture. I hope the whole place comes crashing down around his ears.
We have a lot of money again. People's child is coming. Pleasant. That sounded like a brute. First, get a good picture of you. Shoddy. Remember, I need to kill him in different ways to have interesting, footage. Ow. And put this here. On fire and frozen. Come on. Come on, attack my copy, my clone. Oh hell, the clone went away. Wrong timing, oh well. Yeah, I'm trying to get creative now that we're close enough to the end of the game. Oh hey, everything burned.
Elenor, I know you can hear me. I am inside Sinclair's lifeboat now. Delta cannot reach me here, but you can. You need not die with him. We shall return to the surface together, if you will only step inside and accept your duty. Remember, Elenor, Mummy loves you.
Ah, yes. Mother's testing me. One last game. Fortunately, by now, I'm the world's foremost expert at breaking her rules. I've made my choice, Father. And if needs be, I'll die for it.
You still get, unlike the first game, you kill somebody who is frozen, or you just shatter them when they're frozen, you still get rewards. Also, I'm gonna probably stop shooting the people who are not attacking me, because that's a little messed up. It didn't occur to me.
Kid, I'm sorry. I've locked you in here. Lamb's making me dance on her goddamn strings. I can't stop. You're gonna have to break in here and put me down. Wish there was another way, but I'd rather die a man than live like this.
Well, that makes me feel depressed.
He's right, Father. Mother's betting you'll die in here, or that I'll abandon you before the bombs detonate. We can't save Sinclair now. We need...
Maintenance tunnel, yes. I remember. That could get you near enough to lure me out. Try it, kid. Hurry.
When the person you're trying to kill helps you trying to kill them, like this happened more than once in this game, yeah.
I caught a glimpse of the warden entering the code to the tower today. Last two digits were 7 and 3. Didn't catch the rest. Maybe I can just figure it out, trial and error. Wonder how long that'd take.
Good. Good, son. That's half the code. Now find the rest.
Alright, that's half the code. I heard someone having a conversation above my head.
Son, I built this place and I did rent you out to those plasma trials up at Fontaine. And now I'm paying for it. Wish I had time to make amends. Take the lifeboat, it's all yours. Just don't leave me like this. You're in the tunnel. Ought to give you some kind of jump on me. I hope.
It's weird that he has complete consciousness over what's going on, but simultaneously does not have consciousness of what's going on. It's also interesting how in this game, every single person we found has some sort of direct connection to us. Almost. And you've usually wronged us in some way. Oh, hell. That's not what I was expecting to happen. Let me in. Oh, I can't get in here, can I? No, that just got him out.
Sinclair is moving, Father. Track him down. We need that key.
See, you could input the codes, or you could do something along those lines, which lures him out anyway. I'm gonna hit this up. Grab you. Think that chased him out, good, which means we can go in here and loot the place, which is important.
Lam's attention seems to have drifted from my prisoners to her daughter. Guess she figures they're irredeemable. Now I've got guys clamoring for the next fix of Adam, and I've got to pull teeth to squeeze any out of the good doctor. Guess I'm lucky her treatments kept them too weak to storm the tower. Or they'd have my guts for garters.
That's not working. He's an Alpha series. Lightning, lightning, lightning. Oh, we have cluster grenades now, in case you didn't notice. Highly effective. Whoa!
So long, kid. Thank you.
Now, Father, I'm afraid that ending the lockdown means releasing all the prisoners. So please, be ready before you use that key on the override switch.
Remember, we haven't been collecting little sisters, so they had to add that in somehow.
Ignored my warnings for far too long. I'm taking this into my own hands.
I secured a hack tool to nullify his turrets and subvert the bots. I also figured out the code. It's 2-6.
And that's the code if you wanted it.
Hey, Murphy. It's Dodge. A little baby told me you found out the warden's code.
Let's get some...
Send a message to my cell in Block A.
Hold on. There we go.
Tell me where you hid the code, and I'll consider your debts paid.
I'm gonna set lots and lots of traps, and we're gonna defend ourselves from inside here. I think that's the best choice. But we're gonna need to zap a lot of these. And one more! Ta-da! Let's get it started.
Override engaged. Ending security curfew. Sealing security office temporarily.
Well, they're hitting the traps.
Sinclair died a hero of the Rapture family, Delta. Was he a friend to you, or just a tool? Can you even grasp the difference? And Eleanor, you have chosen Subject Delta over your mother, your people, and the duty of your birth. So be it. You believe this craft will carry Delta to safety, like a spoilt child with a new toy. I have no choice but to take it away.
You can try.
All cell blocks open. All bulkhead seals released.
Oh no. Mother's turned her attention to the lifeboat. We must go there, now!
Well, everything's on fire. Alright, hold on. I need some help. Oops. There we go. Only had to reload my plasmids 3 times. Ah, hell. Alright, come on. Let's go, Eleanor. We've got a bit of a journey ahead of us. Oh, hey! Explosives! I'm in a go-with-what-works situation right now, rather than a let's-use-as-many-different-plasmids and weapons as we can scenario. Though I do get the impression I should load up my rocket launcher.
Tears Eleanor further from me, Delta. Soon, this father obsession will end her. You have left me without want. Before you die, I will take all that you hold dear. Sinclair is just another body in your wake.
Oopsies! Sorry, Eleanor! Alright. Seven heads, 10 horns? That is a very asymmetric creature. Eleanor's probably teleported away by now, so we're safe. Come on.
I was afraid of this. Mother has bombed out the ballast compressors, Father. The lifeboat will be too heavy to launch. Unless... let me think. I think I can boil away the water and get the lifeboat to rise, but I can't generate that much heat alone. It's time to recruit the rest of Mother's little sisters. We're taking them with us. Head to the pediatric wards.
Pediatric. Got it. In a therapy wing. You want me to go this way? You have a multi-part goal. Huh. What's my multi-part goal? Oh, there's one in the infirmary and one in the therapy. Got it. I guess that makes sense. Oh god, pain!
I won't let her take you from me again, Father. Hold on.
Alright. Ooh. Shinies. And a corpse. Don't worry, I'm just searching a corpse that's currently on fire. No biggie. Careful. Oh, that's creepy.
This is not a sermon. I will offer no insight. Every word I speak, you already know.
Mother's people are starting to detonate the charges. We don't have long.
Aw, I like all these paintings, though. Oh, dear. Where'd you go, ma'am? Over here? Yes, over here. Gotcha. I think it's about time I bust out a shoddy for a while.
An autograph.
With this damn faulty memory of mine, I need to record a clue so I don't forget the key code. To secure this log somewhere.
I'm sorry, what? That's a very unique code. Actual puzzles? No, not in this game. I refuse. Oh, this place is getting grim.
My father was a physician. He raised me not to echo him, but to model the world as it ought to be. I was to teach a simple moral
shoddy. There we go.
Each choice as though the world must bear it. Each life or death for the common good. He called it the triage imperative and would laugh without smiling.
That's a terrifying thought. Also, it's sort of tangential to this, but sometimes you just gotta remind yourself, what's ethical is not always what's right or moral. Ethical and moral are two different things.
I expect we'll be fighting our way inside.
There are a lot of people who are just unable to fight back, and here's the thing. Yeah, it lists them as enemies on your crosshair, which is grim. I'm gonna avoid killing random people, like I said before. But that's an interesting choice on their end. Apologies for the cut. Oopsies. Had to do something real fast. Uh-oh. My controller's vibrating. Oh, hi! I don't need to take any pictures of you, so frag grenade! Remember, explosions don't hurt me because of one of the upgrades.
When you've cleared them out, I'll need a signal. Push the call button on the window there, and then I'll proceed.
Alrighty, let's get something. Uh-oh. Excuse me. I need your help, sir. Thank you. Oh! Ow! Excuse me! You're right next to him! Useless, useless turret. Where are you? You're just gonna keep appearing up there, aren't you? Good. The sentry manages to keep up with the Houdini splicers much better than I do. Oh, wait. on, just die. Thank you. I keep getting A pluses and it's still not enough. Oh. Hi. Thank you, Elenor. Yo, sweetheart. Those poor Houdini splicers. They keep going up to the same place. You would think I should set up traps or something up there. So maybe take advantage of that? That would be a smart thing to do. I like the ending music sting. Very dramatic.
I'll wake the children up. They're stronger than they know. With their help, I should be able to boil off the water and get us all out of here. Go on ahead, Father. I'll free them as quickly as I can, just as you showed me.
I'm a little curious how the scene plays out if you didn't save the children. If you just straight up murdered a bunch of them. Go away. There are much more useful plasmids than the lightning throwing one, but I prefer it, you know, the classic. Now, it's not telling us to go this way, but I'm gonna. Oh, this is a tough hack. Whew. Wait, I just walked into some atom. Okay, sure. Wow, look at all of these goodies. All these useless goodies. Except for the atom I just walked into. Oops. Just hit him with a remote hack dart. Ow. Come on, shoot me. Shoot me. No, that's not shooting. Ow. Ow. Shoot me with your gun. Hit him with a clipboard until he learns to behave. Man, when you guys decide to run at somebody, you really are dedicated to the whole idea of running someone. I can respect that. Almost. I just have so many resources now.
Need I remind you, Sinclair, that Lamb is your problem now. She's no longer a citizen of Rapture. That was the proviso. You wanted her expertise, and now you have it. Ryan Industries is your client, and we require test candidates from among your charges. The protectors are...
Oops.
You are not saving them, Delta. No matter how pure your intent, the surface is not paradise. But perdition. I would sooner see them drown.
Look, Father, I know you may not have wanted a daughter, but love is just a chemical. We give it meaning by choice. I will be damned if I let Mother take you away from me again.
Love is more than a chemical, I'm afraid. May sound weird, someone of the with a psychology degree saying that, but that's because there's a difference between biological psychology and a lot of other types of psychology, and I don't always agree with biological psychology in all respects. Is there anything I want? I don't think there is. I think I'm pretty much set for what I want to do. Yeah, I guess we'll just keep as is. I mean, there's some upgrades to plasmids we're using, but Adam is precious at this moment since we're not collecting any. To the infirmary! Rude! That poor corpse wasn't doing anything.
That's another charge gone. We have to keep moving. If this building falls, we're all dead.
Oh, that looks like it hurt. consider that, apparently. Oh, there's security cameras in here, and I was not paying attention. Hi! By all accounts, that should have caught me. Stop it! Security camera, do work. Speaking of security, there's something in there, but I can't really get to it. Ow! Okay, who's the jerk? Alright, let me see if I can deal with this. There! Really? That was like the one pixel in the entire thing where I could have pressed to zap myself. Good job, Haven. Goodies, goodies, goodies!
Elenor was to be a composite of all Rapture's genius. The first living utopian. Serving the world at large with no regard for herself. To force consciousness on such a being is to tear its wings away. That was your gift to her, Delta. Just as she hoped. You must be very proud.
It's funny how similar Lamb's and Andrew Ryan's ideologies end up becoming when you burn, distill them down.
Guards tried to make him take another dose of whatever the hell it is they're pumping into him, and he managed to take on all four of them at once. Snapping legs and arms, blood everywhere. They say one of the guys might not even wake up. I wish I could be that free.
Yep, that's how they define freedom. Complete subjugation to the will of another, apparently. The freedom from having to have a choice. It's not an entirely foreign concept. Oh god, pain!
Steady, Father. Don't let go now.
Wake up! Why don't you wake up?
Tell me I zapped someone. No? Doesn't sound like I zapped someone. Oh! Hi! Bye! Sucks for you. Alrighty. Where are we headed, oh wonderful arrow? Alright, what do I want to hit you with? I want to hit you with something special. Nice and special. The Alpha series and the Splicers around here don't exactly get along. It's a real shame. Let's put that on, switch to a different weapon. Oh, I just saw something. That was creepy. Yeah, there's a lot of hidden Alpha series around here. Thank you. Anything in here for me?
Guess I had the wrong of it when it came to Dr. Lamb. She explained how my cravings for control were rotting me out from the inside. We found all these incidents in my log where I made it easy for a convict to get the jump on me. Just so I could bloody punish him. Christ. But I believe I can do some good down here now. With the family. We have a shot at surviving that fucking bedlam going on up there. Maybe even take the city back.
That's certainly one theory. Or, you know, you could make it worse. But that's how she preys on people. That's how she gets them to do what they want, what she wants. Telling them what they want to hear.
No insight. Every word I speak, you already know.
Every eye for the wee. No! Yeah, I've been using a lot of auto-hack darts lately. I'm lazy. Oh, hell. Come on. More auto-hack darts. Shoddy, come out to play.
Now, one of the girls managed to dart past the nurse today and throw herself over the railing in the lobby. Not certain if she was trying to end her own life or merely escape. But by the way, her legs had healed by the time I managed to get down to the first floor where she lay. Now, without proper setting, the rapid healing process had fused her bones back together at odd angles. We had to re-break and set them almost a dozen times, each due to the small window of viability. Now, those children may be immortal, but I can verify they feel pain. Advising Dr. Lamb on higher doses of sedatives to keep this from happening again.
Grim. Grim, 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 grim. One after another, every single one of these things just makes you feel more sorry for everybody involved. But for now, I think that's a good place to stop, because we need to try and save the rest of the little sisters so that they can help us escape. That said, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you folks next time.